Hello designers, in today's tutorial we're going to be using Affinity Designer and Affinity Photo to create a tileable, seamless texture. We'll then create a style from this where we can use it over and over again in our projects. Let's go. Just a quick note before I start, any shortcuts I use will appear in the bottom left-hand corner. I am using a Mac, but in the description I'll try and add any Windows shortcuts too. Okay, so we've opened Affinity Designer and we need a new document. We're going to go to Layout and just type in 1000 pixels by 1000 pixels, PPI 72, and color, we're going to choose RGB 8. Now press Create. So our document is a perfect square, and basically this is going to be the tile that we're going to use to duplicate and make a seamless texture. So we can use it over and over again in future projects. So the first thing we're going to need is an image. So we're going to head on up to Window and then go to Stock, click on that. And then the stock tab appears and you'll have two options, Pixabay and Pexels. Just choose Pixabay and type in here blue wall cat. Press return. And we're going to use this first image here, picture of a cat and a wall in the background that's blue. It's got some nice texture on this wall, which is why I want to use this one. The photo has loaded up and you can see it's really zoomed in. So I'm just going to hold down Command, click on one of the corners and drag it in so we can see the full photo. So basically what we want is just a portion of this. We're going to choose like a square amount of the wall. So what I'm going to do is just drag that out again, try and line it up to where I think it should be. Basically, our mission here is to choose a portion of the wall that doesn't have too much variation. So if I zoom in, we don't want this because it would be too much editing for us later. So I'm just gonna choose something like, yeah, something like this will do. So what we're gonna do is head on up to File and Edit in Photo. See how easy this is? I'll just click on it and it opens Affinity Photo on a new screen for me. So I'm just gonna swipe over to it. There it is, we're in Affinity Photo. Very easy. So our aim now with this square is that if we copied and pasted it and put it right next to each other, there'd be no line, no seam that's gonna make people think this is repeating over and over again, like those cheap computer games we used to play. So what we're gonna do is just click on the Move tool. Our layer is selected there. And we're going to head on up to Filters, Distort, and then we're going to go down to Affine. Click on that, and this little Affine box appears. What we're going to do now is offset the axis of X and Y. So I'll just quickly show you. If I drag this slider across, you can see if I zoom in, there's like this definitive line here, and we don't want that. So what we're going to do with the X axis is just press 50, press Return, and I'll press 50 on the Y axis. Press return. And now you can see when we zoom in, there's these lines, and that's the thing that we don't want. So we're going to sort that out now. I'm going to click on apply. So there's a number of ways of getting rid of these seams. I'll just run you through a couple of them. We're not going to spend too long doing it, but you can spend as long as you want to get it perfect. So one of the ways is we grab the rectangular marquee tool and just click on that. And I'll just click from the top and drag down like that. And then if I just hold down Control on the keyboard and click and drag, I can add another one. You see, I'm kind of just selecting where the seams are. From this point, I can go over to our In Painting brush tool. Click on that. And then I could just click and drag around, just paint in everywhere where this cross is like that. And I'll let go and it should sort it out. There we go. That was pretty quick. If I press Command D to deselect this marquee tool, Command D. Let's have a look at what it's done. Actually, it's done a pretty good job when we zoom out. So that's one way of doing it. I'll just press Command Z to go back a few steps. Another way of doing it is to head on over to the Clone Brush tool. Click on that, and you can make it bigger and smaller by clicking the left bracket key or right bracket key. So see, I'm making it bigger there. You can play around with the hardness here. Basically, with this tool, what we want to do is we're going to sample an area that we want to copy over to here. So hold down Option or Alt on your keyboard and select an area. So maybe I want to select this area here. And then you can see as I drag it over, it's going to copy it over and I just paint from there to try and hide any seams. So you can go around doing that. And obviously it's very soft on the sides right now. You can make it totally hard, but then it would be really obvious. So play around with those settings until you get it right. And just sample a lot. So over here, maybe you want to sample from this section. Paint a little bit, sample from over here, paint a little bit. So anyway, just for time's sake, I'm just gonna go back, Command Z, and I'm gonna do it the quick way. So marquee tool, this is how quick you can do it. Marquee tool, select that, hold down Control, click click, drag, go to the in painting brush, click on that, paint everywhere that you've selected, let go, it will make its in painting magic, and then just press Command D to get rid of the marquee tool. So looking at it, it looks okay. Now I can just touch it up slightly with the clone brush tool. So our aim at this point would be to just get rid of anything that might repeat again and make people think that it's badly done. And there's only so much I can do on this tutorial, I guess, without speeding it up. And just be careful of how soft you go, because that also can be quite evident when you zoom out. See, it looks a little bit softer. So what we can do at this point, we can actually look at the Affine again to see whether it worked or not. So I'm going to head on up to Filter and Distort and Affine again. We're just going to drag these sliders left and right just to see if we can see any seams here. So it's looking pretty good. I will drag the Y axis as well to see if there's anything there. Right now I can't see anything, but in reality, if I just put it to 50%, in reality, if there's a very smooth section and a very coarse section, that is going to show up when you start repeating it. You can play around with the tools I've shown you to even it out, and once you're done, just press apply. Okay, so from this point, let's say you're happy with this texture, you can go ahead and save it as a JPEG on your desktop. So head on up to File, Export, and then it's a JPEG, and then just press Export. Let's name it Blue Texture, and press Save. Okay, from this point, I want to open Affinity Designer again, so I'm just going to go on File and Edit in Designer. I'll switch over to Designer and have a look at it. So from this point, I basically just want to test it out to see if it worked, see if it looks good. So I'm going to go ahead and create an artboard here. I'm just going to click on the Artboard tool on the top left, and I'm going to click Insert Artboard. And I want another one to play around in, so I'm just going to click it once more, Insert Artboard. Now we have two. So with this one here, I'm just going to zoom in and create a little cube. So I'm just going to click and drag out whilst holding Shift, and I'll just make it sort of blue. Yeah, that's it. And now I'm just going to convert this to curves, just because I'm going to make a little cube for you so we can test this out. Kind of like a concrete block, I guess. So I've converted it to curves, and I'm just going to press Command-C, Command-V to copy that. I'm with the node tool selected right now, which is A. Just select two of those and click and drag it up, maybe somewhere like that. And again, I'm going to select this first one and press Command-C, Command-V. I've made another copy, so I'm just going to select these nodes. And in fact, I should have selected these two. And then I grab this node. Because snapping's on, I can snap it to up here. So now it's kind of like we have a cube. I just show you, make that a little bit lighter. So now we're going to apply that texture to this cube. So what we're going to do, I've clicked on the Move tool. Just going to select this first one here, and I'm going to go over to the gradient tool. So I'm going to click on that, and then I'm going to go up to type. It says solid right now. We want to select bitmap. So I'll select that, and now it's opened a pop-up box where we can choose the saved JPEG that we saved earlier, blue texture. Click on open, and now you'll notice our texture is in there, and it also has these handles. We can play around with these handles. So if I select the middle one, I can move it around like this. If I select this one, I can make it smaller and bigger. And you can also squash it in by holding Control on the keyboard. Just on this one, you see it slightly changes, and I can click and drag it in to squash it. I don't want to do that right now, so I'll just press Command Z to go back a step. So this is looking pretty good. What I'm going to show you is when you zoom out, you can see when you zoom out a lot, you can start seeing how the texture is kind of repeating in a bad way. So spend a bit of time making sure that, you know, there's not too much difference between the dark areas, like the coarse areas like that, and the lighter areas. So I'll leave it about here. One cool trick you can do, instead of continuously going over to Type, Fill, Bitmap, choosing it, you could just head on over to this tool here, which is Style Picker tool. So I'll select that one. And now with this, I want to select the style that we've just added, and that is basically our texture. So I'll use the dropper tool to click, and you see it selected and added it to this section. Now if I select this one here, just click on it once, it will also apply that same style, which is really fast and cool. So obviously right now there's no difference between the front and the top and the side. So what you can also do, if you're making a cube, I don't know why you do that, but if you're making a cube, so top section here, I can just select it. and go down here to adjustments. I can just click on recolor. So I've clicked on that and it's made it red for some reason. You can just choose whichever color you want and change the saturation. So I'll just click the lightness and just make it a lot more brighter, and I'll bring down the saturation. And I can do the same with the right-hand side as well. So that's selected. I go to recolor. Now you don't have to do it this way because it's just if you want to change the color of it real quick, you can do that. And I'll bring the lightness down on this side. Anyway, you get the idea, but there's a much easier way of doing this, of course. And I'm going to show you how that works. So if I just delete the sides here, we have a perfect square and we like this texture, don't we? From this point, we can save this as an actual style. So over on the right-hand side, you'll see we have styles panel. And if I go down to test, this is one where I test out different styles. And you can make one by just going to this burger menu and then just add new category. And from here anyway, I've selected this square. I could just right click on it. And if we go all the way down to the bottom, you can see create style. So if I click on create style, you see it's popped up there. It says style 2. You can right click on it and rename it. Blue texture. Press return. So now that we have a style, we can actually just apply this just in one click to anything that we've got. So I've made another file just so that I can show you how quick we can add this texture. So I'm going to open up that. It's a test file. There it is. I've kind of made a shed, if you will. And I just want to apply this texture to just a couple of sides of the walls. So this one here, I'll just click on blue texture. So click and it's applied. Excellent. I click on this side and I'll click on blue texture again. Click. That easy. Now, of course, at this point, because that's in the shadow here, I can make this darker. And just for this example, I'm going to click on adjustments down here again, and I could choose levels even, and just bring down a gamma slightly, just make it slightly darker like that. You can play around and add loads of these adjustments. So I can click on it again and click on HSL. And from there, I can bring down the saturation a bit if I want. That's actually being applied to the full image right now. You see here, this is two of our walls in the layers panel, and I only want it to apply to this one. In fact, I should probably name this, I'll just call it dark side. And the HSL adjustment is up here. All I have to do is just click and drag it onto our dark side. And then when I open it up, you can see all these adjustments are here. I could just switch between them and get the right style that I want. So I could just drag that down now, and it only affects that portion of the wall. Okay, so you can see how easy it is to do. Also, remember, if you want to make the texture smaller or bigger, you just press on the gradient tool on the left-hand side, or just press G on your keyboard. That is the shortcut. And this pop-up appears with the handles, and you can just drag it in and out wherever you want. So that is how you make a seamless texture from a photo by adding it into Affinity Designer, making the changes in Affinity Photo, bring it back, make it into a style that you can just use over and over again. You can build a whole catalog of this, make your life easier in the future. And just before I end this tutorial, I'll just select the roof and just add this other style that I made ages ago. It's a camo texture. Just make a camo roof. Very odd. Okay, that's it for this tutorial. If you enjoyed it, let me know. Leave a comment, give it a like, and if you haven't subscribed already, go ahead and do that. And I will catch you on the next video. Take care.